My laboratory works on polymers to integrate medical devices with the human body. And one class of these devices is called brain-machine interfaces. So brain-machine interfaces are exciting and important because we can record signals from the brain or other parts of the nervous system, but we can also stimulate those same tissues. And so we can do things like control disease states or evoke interesting new therapeutic responses. And so the question that we ask is, how do you harmonize a flexible, wet, curvilinear brain with a rigid, brittle, stiff electronic device that can record from that brain? In recent years, my laboratory has focused on a new class of materials called hydrogel-based electronics. And so what hydrogel-based electronics are essentially really soft, squishy electronics that can better match the properties of the brain. So imagine a bowl of Jell-O, and that can represent the properties of your brain, more or less. And so now imagine putting a plastic fork inside of that bowl of Jell-O and moving it around. And so this is a sort of representation of what it's like to insert a rigid electronic device into a soft structure like the brain. And so my laboratory thinks about making that fork, and instead of having a rigid, plastic, brittle structure that can injure the brain, we try to make that fork into essentially another piece of Jell-O that can merge seamlessly with the tissue in the brain. And so what we've been able to do is design new classes of materials and processes that can effectively meld electronics with hydrogel-based structures that are also very soft. So brain-machine interfaces can be used to record activity from the central nervous system, and that's a widely studied field. But what's more interesting recently is that we're understanding that the nervous system that innervates our visceral organs also has a therapeutic dimension to them. So if we can design devices that can seamlessly merge with the peripheral nerves, then that means we can stimulate them, we can record from them, and we can understand and alter disease states that are not related to our central nervous system, but organs like the pancreas or the liver or the heart. We think that new materials can bring to bear new kinds of solutions to seamlessly meld synthetic electronic devices with the human body. If we're able to do that effectively, then we're able to transform our understanding of disease states, but also open up new kinds of methodologies to alter those disease states and improve and extend human life.